Searching for any new source of water.
KPIX5's John Ramos shows us some of those people are turning to a mysterious method thousands of years old.
What do you do when there's a serious drought and your entire livelihood relies on having water? It turns out the secret to finding more water may be as basic as getting in touch with your feelings. This close to harvest, the Napa Valley grapes glow like jewels on the vine. But on this day, we're hunting for a different kind of treasure. We're looking for water. So vineyard manager Mark Neal has brought in his secret weapon, Rob Thompson, who has an ironic description of his business during a drought.
Swamped. I'm booking out, 3 to 4 weeks in advance.
Rob practices the mysterious art of dowsing, locating underground water with nothing more than a pair of bent steel rods. He touches his rods to the ground to reset them, then begins to move them. When they point toward water, the rods cross, almost like they become magnetized. Rob believes underground objects like water create changes in a faint electromagnetic field.
And think of us as one big radio, and we tune into that change in the magnetic field, and so we pick it up.
Well drilling costs thousands of dollars, so when Mark Neal hires Rob, he's backing it with a sizable investment, and his faith has been well rewarded.
In 25 years, he's never hit a dry well for you?
Never hit a dry well yet. Now, don't jinx that today.
The well on this 50-acre vineyard is starting to fail, so Rob begins searching for a new site, eventually finding three spots and identifying the exact place to drill.
Here we go.
The rods even tell him how deep to drill and how much water it is likely to produce. But despite his 40 years of success, scientists still say dowsing is a lot of bunk.
What's your response when people say there's really nothing to this?
I just hand them a set of dowsing rods, and some of them can do it, and they're like, what's going on?
So I decided to try it myself, holding the rods as gently as I could.
Okay, I am not moving this. It's moving itself. That's amazing.
Rob believes we are moving the rods, subconsciously, tapping into some sixth sense. And while he can't totally explain it, after 40 years, he doesn't doubt it's real. And neither does Mark Neal.
I won't take on a project unless I can use Rob as my dowser on any project, for sure.
Farming is a practical pursuit, but it's dependent on the weather, which no one can really predict. So if growers can have faith in something that mysterious and complex, why not for something as simple as two steel rods? In Napa Valley, John Ramos, KPIX5.
Now, Rob Thompson says his sixth sense extends to other things as well and has been hired to find oil, gas, and mineral deposits, and even an occasional shipwreck.
Well, he's always employed. We know that.
Can he predict the weather, though? Maybe.
I guess the point would be that he doesn't have to if he can find water underground, but we'll take a shot at it anyway and see what's in store for us through the rest of this week. The good news is that the onshore wind...